Aloha. I'm Andy. In this video I will show the 2.14 BIOS settings for the HP Compaq 8200 Elite PC. The 2.14 BIOS version fixes these issues. Corrects an issue where the replicated setup feature of BIOS setup could overwrite unit-specific system ID data when used to restore BIOS configuration data on different units. Fixes an issue with handling USB devices that are hot plugged in DOS. Fixes an issue that was preventing a USB mouse from working in DOS. Fixes an issue where the power supply type was sometimes reported incorrectly through SMBIOS. Corrects the reported smart error codes from hard drive self-tests. Fixes master boot record post-error reporting to properly indicate when a drive with a saved MBR is swapped out. Fixes an issue where selecting F5 disable for some devices in the BIOS setup, boot order menu was not being saved. Fixes support for the lowest processor idle state when Intel Text LT support is enabled in the BIOS setup, system security menu. Fixes the UID field interface in the BIOS setup, security, system IDs menu so that it cannot be accidentally overwritten. Fixes issues with the reporting of parallel port resources in BIOS setup, advanced, onboard devices menu. Adds a post-error message for a memory size change, it no longer reports the same error message as a memory failure. Fixes the startup menu UEFI application launcher for some application types that wouldn't correctly execute. Updates the PXE option ROM to v1.3.76 to fix a timeout when requesting an IP address in secure network environments. Corrects an issue where certain BIOS 32 PCI calls could cause a protection fault. Fixes an issue where the BIOS setup option unconfigure AMTME in the AMT configuration menu would not complete if a BIOS setup password was set. Fixes an issue where MS Windows 7 or Vista will fail to install as an EFI boot source if previously installed in the same mode. Updates Intel processor microcode to the latest version. Adds the capability to update the BIOS from a data CD in BIOS setup or the startup menu. Improves the performance of securing memory after warm boots, when memory must protected for security purposes. Improves BIOS setup interface to prevent drive lock and network server mode from both being enabled at the same time. The two features should be mutually exclusive. If you are interested about the BIOS settings for this PC, then please continue to watch this video. From this slideshow you can make a picture what settings you could change for better performance. The most important settings are, BIOS update utility, boot configuration, boot option priority, SATA configuration, hardware testing tools, graphics configuration, and so on. Sit back, relax and enjoy the video. If this video was useful to you and do you want to reward me with a cup of coffee, you can do it by clicking on the link in the description, select one cup and click on the support button. Thanks for watching, don't forget to share, comment, like, and subscribe. See you next time, goodbye.